चैनल ऑफ डिजिटल टू रियल। आपका डिजिटल टू रियल चैनल में स्वागत है। वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व सम ऑफ द मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन विद डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन, वेयर द बूलियन इक्वेशन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज डन थ्रू मल्टीप्लेक्सर। सो यहाँ पे हम कुछ बूलियन इक्वेशन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन मल्टीप्लेक्सर के थ्रू करेंगे और मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस जो गेट एग्जाम में इस टॉपिक पे बेस्ड आए हुए हैं, वी विल सॉल्व। द क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस, फाइंड द इनपुट एक्सप्रेशंस I0, I1, I2, I3 ऑफ अ 4:1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर फॉर द फंक्शन f. f इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ a, b, c, d एंड इज इक्वल टू मीन टर्म्स सिग्मा मीन टर्म 0, 1, 3, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15. So f is a function which is true for the mean term 0, 1, 3, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 15. We have to use out of a, b, c, d, a and b as selection lines. Okay, this has also been mentioned in the question. Use A and B as selection line. So the four options has been given for I0, A, B option, C option and D option has been given. A0, A is I0 is equal to C dash plus D, I1 is D dash, I2 is C plus D dash, I3 is C dash plus D. B is I0 equal to C plus D dash, I1 is equal to D dash, I2 is equal to C plus D dash and I3 is equal to C dash plus D. C option, I0 is equal to C dash plus D, I1 is equal to D, I2 is equal to C plus D dash and I3 is equal to C dash plus D. Option D is I0 is equal to C dash plus D, I1 is equal to D, I2 is equal to C dash plus D and I3 is equal to C plus D. Function f is a Boolean equation which is in terms of variable A, B, C, D. So A, B, C, D can take the value 0, 0, 0, 0 to all ones. You see 1, 1, 1, 1. So, it is true for 16 values. So, there f is a function of a, b, c, d. There would be 16 mean terms. Okay. So, f is true for mean term 0. F is true for mean term 1. F is true for mean term 3. F is true for mean term 4. F is true for mean term 6. F is true for mean term 8, F is true for mean term 10, F is true for mean term 11, F is true for mean term 12, F is true for mean term 13 and F is true for mean term 15. S1, A it is mentioned, then S1 is a selection line and B is also a selection line. A and B are the selection line, S1 and S0. So, select, what are the options, what are the combination the selection line have? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Okay. Now here is the implementation table for a 4 cross 1 marks. For a 4 cross 1 marks, there would be 4 inputs I0, I1. I2 and I3, 4 inputs would be there and 1 output would be there and 2 selection line would be there, that is A and B, S1 and S0. Okay, so I0, I1, I2, I3 and here are the 4 rows. Okay, so these are the 4 rows. How do we find these 4 rows? Now see, when the AB is selection line is A dash B dash, that is 0 0 0 0 all four combination 0 1 2 3, 0 1 2 and 3, 0 1 2 3. When selection line 0 1 0 1, AB is 0 1, again 0 1 2 3. Then selection line 1 0, selection line is 1 1 0. Okay, again 1 1 0 0 0 to 1 1. Selection line is 1 1. Okay, AB is 1 1. So 0 0 to 1 1 3. Now this is the implementation table for expressing the Boolean equation for multiplexer 4 cross 4, because two input lines are there, two select lines are there, that is why it is a 4 cross 1 multiplexer. So 0 1 2 3 for this one is the combination 0 1 2 3 0 1 2 3 is A1 B1, for A1 B1. Okay, 0 1 2 3 C dash D dash C dash D C D dash C D. This is for 0 1 combination of AB, that is A dash B, 4 5 6 7 mean terms. These are the mean terms I have mentioned. This one I2, corresponding to I2, what is the select line? For select 1 0, that is AB dash. Then mean terms 8 9 10 11. I3, what is the select line? AB. S1 S0 is 1 1. So what is the mean terms? 12 13 14 15. Now out of this, in the question it is already being mentioned, the function f is true for what all mean terms? It is true for 0, it is true for 1, it is true for 3, it is true for 4, it is true for 6, it is true for 8, it is true for 10, it is true for 11, it is true for 12, it is true for 13, and it is true for 15. So I0 is equal to, look at the first column, I0 is equal to C dash D dash plus C dash D plus C D. So C dash D dash plus C dash plus C dot D C dash plus C is, as per the Boolean algebra, Boolean theorem, it is 1. So C dash D dash plus D, so it is equal to C dash plus D dot D dash plus D, it is equal to C dash plus D. You have to look at the my previous videos on Boolean algebra and theorems in order to understand what are the algebraic, what are the theorems available and postulates available in order to solve a Boolean equation. Now I1, I0 is solved. I1 is equal to C dash D dash plus C D dash. If I solve this, I1 is equal to D dash. I2 is equal to C dash D dash plus C D dash plus C D. If I solve it, it is coming as C plus D dash. I3 is equal to C dash D dash plus C dash D plus C D. If I solve it, it is coming as C dash plus D. So the option answer, option is A for this question. Question number 2. It is also a multiple choice question. Okay. So the question goes like this. If only one multiplexer and one inverter are allowed to be used to implement any Boolean equation function of n variable, what is the maximum size of multiplexer needed? Agar hamare paas ek multiplexer hai, agar hamare paas ek inverter hai, ek Boolean equation, ek Boolean function jiske n variables hai, उसको इंप्लीमेंट करने के लिए तो मल्टीप्लेक्सर का साइज क्या होगा? व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम साइज ऑफ मल्टीप्लेक्सर नीडेड? मैक्सिमम साइज क्या होगा? अब इसके ऑप्शन दिए गए हैं 2 raised to n-2 लाइन टू 1, मीन 2 raised to n-2 क्रॉस 1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर, 2 raised to n-1 लाइन टू 1, 2 raised to n-1 क्रॉस 1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर, 2 raised to n plus 2 cross 1, and last one is 2 raised to n plus 1 cross 1. Now let's do the solution. If I have a Boolean function of n variables, okay? If you have a Boolean function of n variable, then how many variable would be used for select line at max? It is n minus 1 is used for select line at maximum. Now, number of input line possible for n minus 1 select line is, अगर आपके पास n minus 1 select line है, तो कितने input line possible होंगे? 2 raised to n minus 1, वो आपको पता है. अच्छा, now you have used n minus 1 variable for select line, how many variable are remaining for having the input line? Then I will have only one variable. So, I will keep only one variable for input. Hence, if variable name is A, then A dash is obtained by one inverter. आपके पास एक maximum, एक multiplexer allowed है और एक inverter allowed है. N minus 1 तो हमने select line में ले लिया. तो आपके पास input lines है 2 raised to N minus 1. अब 2 raised to N minus 1 जी input line है, that will use only one variable that is left. A, A dash और दूसरा हो सकता है 0 and 1. Okay. Now in order to obtain A dash, we will need one inverter. So the maximum size of multiplexer is 2 raised to N minus 1 line to 1. 2 raised to N minus 1 is to 1 multiplexer is the maximum size that is allowed. So answer is B. Now question number 3. How many 2 is to 1 mux are required to implement 2 input NAND gate, NOR gate and XOR gate? So we have to make use of 2 is to 1 mux. Hame 2 is to 1 mux ka hi use karna hai. Implement karne ke liye 2 input NAND gate, 2 input NOR gate and 2 input XOR gate. Now you have to tell me, you have to tell how many of 2 is to 1 is used. Aapke paas jo option hai, A 233, B 322, C 222, D is 332. Solution. So this is the 2 input NAND gate. Let it be the output is X and 2 input A and B. So this is the truth table of the NAND gate. Any of the input is 0, output is 1. Both the inputs are 1, output is 0. That is the NAND gate. Now we will have a mux, 2 input 1 mux. That means I need to have one select line. B I have kept as the select line. 2 is to 1 mux. Okay, 2 is to 1. One select line, that is B. Inputs are 2 and 1 is the output. Inputs are I0 and I1. Okay. And one variable is left to be used for the input of the mux. So I can have the A dash and A. So 0, 0. In these two combinations, A is A dash. And here it is A. Okay. So A dash. So for 0 mean term and 1 mean term, A dash is used. So 0 and 1 A dash is used, and for 2 and 3 mean term A is used. And for what all mean term, this truth table is 1. So it is 1 for 0, it is 1 for 1, it is 1, it is for 2, it is 1 for 3, when both the inputs are 1, 1, it is 0. So 0, 1, 2. So I0 is equal to, what is I0 is equal to? A dash plus A is equal to 1. Okay, and I1 is equal to, for A dash only it is true, mean term is valid, so A dash. Suppose it is 2 cross 1 mux, so inputs are I0 is 1 and I1 is A dash, and B is the select line and X is the output. Now A dash, that is the NOT gate, okay. So how to implement the inverter with 2 cross 1 mux? Here is the implementation of the inverter with 2 cross 1 mux. So when A is 0, I0 is selected, that is 1. I1, this is the I1 to the next flip-flop, next stage flip-flop. it is 1, that is output is 1. If A is 0, output is, when A is 1, output is 0. Then this portion I will connect to the input of this one, I1. So the NAND gate implementation using 2 cross 1 marks would look like this. Okay, 2 cross 1 marks, I0, I1, A is the select line, this is the NOT gate, okay, and this one is the NOR gate, NAND gate. As a whole, this one is the NAND gate. Hope you understood the explanation. Now the NOR gate implementation with 2 cross 1 marks. So this is the NOR gate. Symbol of the NOR gate, NOR gate. This is the truth table of the NOR gate. You know that both the inputs are 0. Output is 1. Both the inputs are 0, output is 1. And for rest of them, that is either of the input is 1, output is 0. For 2 cross 1 marks, 1 select line. So S0, SB. Similarly, like NAND gate we solved, no? I0, I1, A dash A. The mean term for which the Y is true is 0. So it has been circled. So I0 is equal to A dash and I1 is equal to, none of the mean term, 1 or 3 are circled. So I1 is equal to 0. Now the implementation of 2 cross 1 for NOR gate. Okay. So here is the, for B select line, I0 is A dash and I1 is 0. And here is the output white of the NOR gate. How to implement A dash? I have shown for NAND gate. How I have implemented the inverter, similarly I have implemented the inverter. Here the inverter output would be connected to I0. So here it would be the implementation of the NOR gate. How many muxes, 2 cross 1 muxes needed in order to implement the NOR gate? 2. 1 and 2. Let's do now the XOR gate. Here is the symbol of the XOR gate. Here is the truth table of the XOR gate. Z is the output of the XOR gate. It is true when either of A or B is, any one of B and A is, B or A is 1. When both the A and B are 0, 0, Z is 0, both are 1, 1, it is 0. Here is the implementation, I0, I1, A dash A, 0, 1, 2, 3, Z is true for 1, Z is true for 2, I0 is equal to A, I1 is equal to A dash. Now here is the 2 cross 1 marks, B is the select line, I0 is A and I1 is equal to A dash, and here it is the output Z, I0, I1, this is the inverter mux, mux implementation, 2 cross 1 implementation of the mux, 2 cross 1 mux implementation of the inverter. I will connect the inverter, where I will connect, I will connect it this input. So this is the 2 cross 1 mux implementation of the XOR gate. How many muxes are required to implement XOR gate? 2 cross 1 mux required is 2. So answer is 2, 2, 2. Answer is C. Hope you like the video. Hope I am able to provide the important, able to solve the important question on the topic of Boolean function implementation with multiplexer. I will solve few more questions in my next video. Do comment for the video. Do subscribe the channel. Do share with your friends. Okay, I would like to provide more and more useful video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.